Hi, this is Shubham from Monist View, and today in this podcast we will discuss about a short straddle strategy. What is this strategy, advantages, disadvantages, basic adjustment, etc. If you want to read the article regarding this, the link of the article is in description. Let's start about short straddle. So what is a short straddle? A short straddle is an option strategy comprised of a selling both a call option and a put option with the same strike price and expiry. It is used when the trader believes the underlying asset will not move significantly higher or lower over the life of an option contract. The maximum profit is the amount of premium collected by the writing option. The potential loss can be unlimited, so it's typically a strategy for a more advanced trades. What is the basics of a short straddle? In a short straddle, allows trader to profit from the lack of movement in the underlying asset rather than having to place directional bets hoping for a big move either higher or lower side. Premium are collected when the trade is open with the goal to let both the put and call expiry worthless. However, chances that the underlying asset close exactly at the strike price at the expiration are low, and that leaves to a short straddle owner the risk for this assignment. However, as long as the difference between the asset price and the strike price is less, the premium collected, the trader will make a profit. Advanced traders might run this strategy to take the advantage of a possible decrease in implied volatility. If implied volatility is unusually high without an obvious reason for it is being that way, the call and put may be overvalued. In this case, the goal would be to wait for a volatility to drop and when the close the option for a profit without waiting for expiration. Let's understand what are the key calculations. Maximum loss when the strike price of an underlying asset is increasing would be price of an underlying asset less the strike price of a call option less net premium received. In case of an underlying asset is decreasing its value, then the loss would be the strike price of a put option less the price of an underlying asset less the premium received. The maximum profit is the total net premium paid less any trade commission or brokerages. This loss occurs when the price of an underlying asset equals the strike price of an option at expiration. Let's discuss what are the different advantages of this strategy. Number 1. In a short straddle option strategy, we sell options. If there is a no movement, then the theta decay will give us a good amount of profit. Second advantage would be a short straddle option strategy is useful when there is no strong directional moves expected. Third, if we carry overnight long straddled option strategy, then also there are chances of a profit due to theta decay. Fourth, a short straddle option strategy require comparatively less skill as it require no or less volatility in the market if we compare with a long straddle option strategy. Let's discuss what are the disadvantages. Number 1. In short straddle option strategy, the margin requirement is comparatively high as we short our position, which exposes us to theoretically unlimited risk. Second, any black swan event or some directional move can lead into a bleeding on one of the leg, which leads to a losses. Third, in a short straddle option strategy, if we carry overnight position without hedging, then we are exposed to huge vega and delta move. So what is the bottom line? A short straddle option strategy is a huge margin option strategy to take advantage of a theta decay, but we will expose to huge vega and delta move. So that is all about a short straddle option strategy. If you want to read the article, then the full article is in our blog and the link for the same is in the description. Thank you guys for joining with us. This is Shubham from Monist View signing off.